Welcome to another line upon line Bible study, going verse by verse through the book of 1 Timothy. 1 Timothy chapter 2 and verse 13. For Adam was first formed, then Eve. Last week we looked at the proper order and conduct for a local church according to 1 Timothy chapter 2 verses 11 and 12. And the reason that God intended for the man to be the spiritual leaders of the local church, 1 Timothy chapter 3 and verse 1, especially as it pertains to pastors and deacons. Paul used the example or illustration of Adam and Eve in verses 13 and 14 as to why the local church is established the way it is. Paul also reminds the reader that the order of creation or formation of mankind in the Garden of Eden was Adam first and Eve second. We see this by going back to Genesis chapter 2, starting in verse number 7. And the Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground, and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul. Verse 18. And the Lord God said, it is not good that the man should be alone. I will make him an helpmeet for him. So the wife, Eve, is intended to be a helpmeet, not a usurper, but a helpmeet. Let's look at verse 21. And the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam, and he slept. And he took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh instead thereof. And the rib, which the Lord God had taken from man, made he a woman, and brought her unto the man. And Adam said, this is now bone of my bones, and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. Therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. And they were both naked, the man and his wife, and were not ashamed. So the word formed and the word made are interchangeable here, but the Bible says that God formed both Adam and Eve. He formed Adam out of the dust of the ground, and he formed Eve out of the rib that was taken out of Adam. Therefore, she is called woman because she came out of Adam's womb. Let's look at Genesis or Jeremiah chapter number 1. And we'll see this thing here again, where God forms man. Jeremiah chapter 1, and let's look at verse number 5. Before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. And before thou camest forth out of the womb, I sanctified thee, and I ordained thee a prophet unto the nations. Man is not now formed out of the dust of the ground, but he is formed in the womb of a woman. All right, now the first real family, you know, they call the presidential family the first family. Well, the real first family consisted of a male, husband, and a female, the wife. This shows also how God's perfect order for the home, and when this order gets out of sorts, it leads to destruction. Now, this business about male and female, husband and wife, should be a rebuke to the world's point of view that you can love who you want to love and do what you want to do. It was never God's design or plan or perfect will for anything but a man and a woman to make up a family. We see this in Matthew chapter 19 and verse number 4. And he answered and said unto them, have ye not read that he which made them at the beginning made them male and female? And that's the problem with a lot of the so-called science experts and the philosophers and the leaders of this world, is they've never read the Bible. They only pretend to have read the Bible or pretend to know what the Bible has to say. Look with me in Mark chapter 10 and verse 6. But from the beginning of the creation, God made them male and female. So from the beginning of the creation of mankind, it was intended for male, Adam, to be formed first, then female, Eve, to be made or formed second. And this is God's perfect order. After all, God does all things decently and in order. And may God bless.